This is chapter number 2, From Trade to Territory. From Trade to Territory. The question answer are based on East India Company, how they started with trade and they built a whole empire in our country. So how do we match them? Diwani. This is the right to collect land revenue. Tiger of Mysore is Tipu Sultan. The Faujdari Adalat is the criminal court. Rani Chennamma, she led an anti-British movement in Kittur. This is Rani Chennamma. Then Sipahi, this has come from the word Sipoy. Fill in the blanks. The British conquest of Bengal began with the Battle of Plassey. Hyder Ali and Tipu Sultan were the rulers of Mysore. Dalhousie implemented the doctrine of lapse. This is the lapse. We call it as Vilay ki niti. Maratha kingdoms were located mainly in the part of western part. State whether true or false. The Mughal Empire became stronger in the 18th century. And this is false. Because in 18th century, the only last recognized emperor is Aurangzeb. After that, all were just namesake. It's false. The English East India Company was the only European company that traded with India. This is wrong. Actually, this company was the only English company, UK company, England company, not a European company. Maharaja Ranjit Singh was the ruler of Punjab, and this is true. The British did not introduce administrative changes in the territories they conquered. This is wrong. They did a lot as far as administration is concerned, and still in our government offices, in our courts, in various, fields, you will find what they have done is still imbibed and engulfed. What attracted European trading companies to India? We were having fine qualities of cotton and silk, okay, in India. Indian spices like pepper, cloves, cardamom and cinnamon, they were very famous. What were the areas of conflict between the Bengal Nawabs and the East India Company? So there were various points of conflict, or reasons of conflict. First, the Bengal Nawabs, they asserted their power and autonomy and refused to grant the company's concession. Then they demanded large tributes for the company right to trade, and they denied the company any right to mint coins, and they stopped the company from extending its fortifications, forts, and accusing the company of deceit, they claimed that the company was depriving the Bengal government of huge amounts of revenue, Rajasva, Kar, and undermining the authority of the Nawab. So it was refusing to pay taxes, writing disrespectful or not very good language letters, and trying to humiliate the Nawabs and his officials. So these were the areas of conflict between the Bengal Nawabs and East India Company. How did the assumption of Diwani benefit the East India Company? So the Mughal Emperor in 1765 appointed the company the Diwan of provinces of Bengal, right? So the Diwani allowed the company to exploit the vast revenue resources of Bengal. And this solved a major problem that the company had earlier faced. Although its trade had expanded, it had to buy most of the goods in India, with golds and silver being imported from UK, that is Britain. So the overflow of gold from Britain stopped after the assumption of Diwani. And now revenue from India could finance company expenses. So these revenues, they used to purchase cotton and silk textiles in India, maintain company troops, and meet the cost of building the company fort and offices at Calcutta. now Kolkata. Explain the system of subsidiary or subsidiary alliance. Alliance means those who are like-minded. That means under the system of this subsidiary alliance, Indian rulers were not allowed to have their independent armed forces. They were to be protected by the company but had to pay for these subsidiary forces that the company was supposed to maintain for the purpose of the protection. So if the Indian rulers failed to make payment, the part of their territory was actually taken away as penalty. And the states which had to lose their territories on account of this subsidiary alliance, say, you can say non-payment, were Awadh and Hyderabad. In what way was the administration of the company different from that of Indian rulers? So the administration of company, how it was different from Indian rulers? First, the company divided its administrative units called as presidencies. And there were three presidencies, Bengal, Madras and Bombay. So in India, districts were the main administrative units. Each presidency was ruled by governor and districts were ruled by the collectors. The supreme head of the administration of the company was the governor general. But India, while at that time, the head of the administration was the king. The main job of governor general was to introduce administrative reforms, while the main job of the collector was to collect revenue, taxes, and maintain law and order in his or her district. Describe the changes that occurred in the composition of the company's army. So there are several changes occurred in the composition of this company's army. First, the company began recruitment for its own army, which came to be known as the Sepoy Army. And as the warfare technology changed from the 1820s, the cavalry recruitments of the company's army declined. And the soldiers of the army company or the company's army had to keep pace with changing military requirements. And its infantry regiment is now becoming unimportant. In the early 19th century, the British began to develop a uniform military culture. Soldiers were increasingly subjected to European style training, drill, discipline that regulated their life for more than before. After the British conquest of Bengal, Calcutta or Kolkata grew from a small village to a big city. Find out about the culture, architecture, and the life of Europeans and Indians of the city during the colonial period. So this is, you can get it from internet, you can, you know, ask in the book also, there are so many things given. So Indians were influenced by British culture, architecture and lifestyle. For example, the culture, British influence began because, you know, all were British, rulers were British. Architecture, influenced by the British architecture, that is the fortification of city, churches, etc. Rich Indians started constructing bungalows in English style. And how about the life? Education, clothes, which have some taste of Englishness in them, they became popular. Now we have certain eminent personality of history, Rani Jhansi, Lakshmi Bai, that is Manikarnika, Mahaji Sindhya, Haider Ali, Maharaja Ranjit Singh, Lord Dalhousie, or any other contemporary ruler of your region, you have to collect pictures, stories, poems, and information about them. So, about Rani Jhansi, first is what you are going to get: early childhood observation, marriage, death of husband, adopted son, then fight with the British, then actually died fighting with the British, and history would always remember her as a strong iron lady who fought for her honor. So Lakshmi Bai Manikarnika was born probably on 19 November 1828 in the holy town of Banaras, Varanasi, in a Marathi Brahmin family. Her father was Morpant Tambe. Her father worked for a court of Peshwa of Bithur district. So Peshwa brought Manikarnika up like his own daughter. The Peshwa called her Chabili, which means playful. She was educated at home and was more independent in her childhood than others of her age. Her studies included archery, horsemanship, and self-defense. So Rani Lakshmi Bai was accustomed to ride on horseback, accompanied by a small escort between the palace and the temple. The Rani Mahal, the place of Rani Lakshmi Bai, has now been converted into museum. She died fighting British army bravely to save her state or the place, this Jhansi. Mahadji Sindhya. So Mahadji Sindhya, also spelled as Mahadji Sindhya, like this. Okay, or Mahadji Sindhya, there are certain ways we can write, was a Maratha ruler of the state of Gwalior in central India. Mahadji was instrumental in resurrecting Maratha power in North India after the third battle of Panipat in 1761 and rose to become a trusted lieutenant of the Peshwa, leader of Maratha Empire. And during his reign, Gwalior became the leading state in the Maratha Empire and one of the foremost military powers in India. He accompanied Shah Alam II, that is Mughal Badshah, in 1771 to Delhi in order to restore the Mughals in Delhi. The Marathas were practically at that time ruling Delhi. He annihilated the power of Jats of Mathura, and during 1772-73, in this period, and destroyed the power of Pashtun Rohilas in Rohilkhand and captured Najibabad. His role during the first Anglo-Maratha war was greatest from the Maratha side, since he humbled the British in central India single-handedly, which resulted into the Treaty of Salbai in 1782, where he mediated between the Peshwa and the British. Hyder Ali of Mysore. From 1721 to 1782, he was the Sultan and de facto ruler of Kingdom of Mysore in southern India. Born Hyder Nayak, he distinguished himself militarily, eventually drawing the attention of Mysore rulers. Rising to the post of Dalawai, that is Commander-in-Chief in Krishna Raja Wodeyar II, he came to dominate this monarch and the Mysore government. So he became the de facto ruler of Mysore as Sarvadhikari, that is Chief Minister, by 1761. He offered strong anti-colonial resistance against the military advances of the British East India Company during the first and second Anglo-Mysore wars, and he was the innovator of military use of the iron-cased Mysorean rockets. Then Maharaja Ranjit Singh. Ranjit Singh, he was born to Sardar Maha Singh and Raj Kaur on 13 November 1780 in Gujranwala, Punjab, now in Pakistan. As a child, he suffered from smallpox, which resulted in the loss of one eye. At the time, much of the Punjab was ruled by Sikhs under a confederate Sarbat Khalsa system, which had divided the territory among factions known as the Ranjit Singh's father was the, and here, Mislis. This was known as Mislis. And this Mislis, Ranjit Singh's father was the commander of this Sukar Chakya Mislis and controlled a territory of West Punjab based around his headquarters at Gujranwala. In 1799, Ranjit Singh captured Lahore from the Bhangi Mislis and later made it his capital. This was the first important step in his rise to power. And in the coming years, he bought the whole of the central Punjab from Satluj to Jhelum under his sway. This area includes north of Satluj, that is Jalandhar, Amritsar, Pathankot, and Lahore, Multan, etc. of Pakistan. Lord Dalhousie, a Governor General of India from 1848 to 1856, Lord Dalhousie is one of the most negatively remembered personality in the rule of East India Company. He ruled India with his full efficiency from 1848 to 1856 AD. In India, he was famous for various negative and positive reasons. As a Governor General of India, positives were starting the railway in 1853 for the first time between Bombay and Thane, starting the postal and telegraph services, starting of widow remarriage, completion of Ganges Canal, and reform of Indian civil services. And what were the negatives? East India Company captured the princely state of Punjab in 1849. Second Anglo-Burmese War was there, and doctrine of lapse, it was very controversial, and then annexation of Awadh. These are few more questions that are being solved. So we will have a look this in the second discussion. Till then, thank you so much and take care of yourself.